A few weeks ago, I showed you the Z-Tilt via probe macro for the Sovel SVU6 and Plus3D printers. I have a confession to make. That wasn't my original idea. It was my idea, but originally not for the Sovel printer, but for the Comgo T300, which I was already testing at the time. However, I was not allowed to show you that machine. Since then, the T300 was revealed. You could see Tiny Me in Sovel's debut livestream, along with so much bigger names like Joel the 3D Printing Nerd, Loyal Moses, or our favorite expert, 3D Print Demon. So today, I'm finally able to tell you about my original idea, which will solve the leveling problem I and other reviewers told you about, and which seems to still be present in early batches of the Comgo T300. Namely, the dreadful variations in bed levels out of the box. This is Gergo, and you're watching GergoPrint3D, my emerging YouTube channel with tips and tricks for these printers. I will show my easy solution to the leveling problem of the T300 and take you through the setup process, but first, let me give you a little background. All three of these machines have separate Z motors, which means there is no physical coupling between the two motors lifting the printhead along the Z axis. When these motors are engaged after homing, they will move in unison. That's great. However, as soon as we disengage the motors or turn the printers off, they will start to move out of alignment. This causes the gantry to tilt, making the x-axis uneven with the bed. As a result, the bed leveling becomes inaccurate and the nozzle may not be at the correct distance from the bed, leading to all kinds of issues with the first layer of our prints. Now, the Sovel SVU7 and 7 Plus's design includes independently driven Z motors, which, in conjunction with the inductive probe, can automatically adjust their positions to achieve a perfectly level bed. As described in my Switching to Orca video, Christian Vick's Clipper editions include this auto Z tilt correction before every print. Sadly, however, this is not possible on the other two machines. The Z motors in the SVU6 and T300 share a single driver, so they cannot correct the position of the two sides independently. Instead, they must resort to a more brute force solution. Their motors push the gantry against the frame's upper end stops to align both sides. This method relies on the physical limits of the machine to ensure the gantry is level. At least in these initial T300 units, this method is not only slow and unpleasant to the ear, but also quite inaccurate. In these units, the right end stop seems to be 0.7 millimeters higher than the left, which plays a substantial role in the extensive range of bed level heights we observe. So, what's the alternative? Instead of aligning the gantry at the top, 350 millimeters away from the bed, I created a simple clipper macro that uses the inductive probe to compare the distances from the bed on the two sides and can tell us how we can adjust the Z positions by hand for perfect alignment. And to make those adjustments even easier, I've designed this replacement for the right knob with a practical handle and a dial marked in 5-minute increments. And the best part is that we can assign this new gantry alignment method to the original Z-axis tilt calibrate button on the level calibrate screen on the device. Look, as I press this button, the printer homes the printhead and simultaneously starts heating the bed to the default printing temperature, so thermal expansion is going to be taken into account in the distance measurements, which commence as soon as the target temp is reached. With the T300's hallmark heating speed, this only takes a few seconds. We probe the two sides, and the prompt tells us the amount and direction of the adjustment that is needed. In this case, it tells us 11 minutes counterclockwise. To make our lives easier, we even have direction indicators on the dial, CW and CCW. The marks being 5 minutes apart, I need to turn a little bit more than 2 full marks. We are prompted to press the calibrate button again, and notice, no heat up or even homing is necessary this time. We get a second measurement almost immediately. It seems I have overcompensated. Let's go 2 minutes clockwise this time. Doing a last measurement, we see the printhead returned to the center home position, and the prompt tells us the gantry is all level to 0.02 millimeter, well within the precision range I will soon show you how to set. As soon as we hit this stage, the bed begins to cool down, but don't worry, the motors will remain engaged and logged in sync. This means they are all set and perfectly aligned for our next print. If you've already got your bed mesh dialed in with a level gantry, there's no need to redo that every time you print. The gantry's alignment is the only variable, that's the only thing that might shift, and with this super fast and accurate leveling method, you're good to go. So great, isn't it? Before I show you how you can get all this to work on your T300, please consider rewarding my efforts with a like and be sure to subscribe so you won't miss similar videos improving your 3D printing experience. Setup has two easy parts, hardware and software. We'll start with printing and installing the new knob, then I'll show you how you can add the macro. Get the printable models and the macro from Cults3D. Link up here and also in the description of the video. Use the comment section below. Your feedback is highly appreciated. And if you get the model now, you will also be eligible to any updates and improvements based on this feedback. Both parts can be printed out of PLA, both without supports, but be sure to add a big enough brim on the knob, since it has a pretty small initial footprint. This is the trickier part. For best bed adhesion, wipe your PEI sheet with isopropyl alcohol, and you'll need the Z height well dialed in. Because of extensive use of overhangs, I recommend printing the inner walls first. I also include an Orca project with all my recommended settings. You will see I even slowed down the wall printing speeds for the knob selectively. You can get Orca Slicer with the T300 profiles from Sovo's website. With these settings, printing took just 15 minutes for the knob on my T300. And just shy of 40 minutes for the dial. I think this gray color matches the aesthetics of the printer, but I can imagine printing them from contrasting colors as well. To install, simply remove the original knob on the right side, add the dial first with the logo facing towards the back, make sure it sits flat on the top of the Z column, the new knob is supposed to have a very tight fit. If it is too tight, you can soften the plastic a bit with a heat gun or hair dryer. Just don't make it too soft. If it turns out to be too loose, you can add some tape on the top of the lead screw or reprint the knob scaled down by a percent or so. Ensure the knob is inserted into the dial just enough to avoid any scraping or grinding sounds indicative of friction between them. Now on to the macro. COLTS 3D requires it to be inside a zip file. You will need to extract it and remember which folder you extracted it into. You will need access to the web interface for the next part. If you haven't yet, connect your printer to your Wi-Fi and take note of the IP address of the printer. I show these in my device screen tour video linked above. Punch in this local IP address into the web browser or Orca Slicer running on a computer connected to the same local network. In the mainsail interface, go to the machine page. Here, use this upload file tool or simply drag and drop the macro on the browser window like I do here. Please make sure to watch my previous video on recovering config file backups on Clipper printers, because we are going to edit printer CFG. We add this line, including our macro. It has to come after the original include macro CFG line. Make sure to type the square brackets and all the underscore characters, otherwise you're going to get all kinds of errors. With these changes, we can press save and restart, and we are ready to test. Now, if you preheat the bed to any temperature, I made my macro in such a way that this custom temperature will be used for the Z-tilt calibration. If you don't preheat, it will use the default target temp, which I will show you how to change in a sec. Either way, we go to the very last menu item, both on the left and in the top row, level calibrate. Press calibrate, wait for it to home, heat up, and probe. Adjust the knob, press sure, then calibrate again until we get the prompt, your gantry is level. I recommend doing a bed mesh at this point using the new perfectly level gantry. From now on, however, it will be enough to do this quick Z-tilt calibration before printing with the default temperatures. Finally, the promised optional customizations. First, look into the Z-tilt macro. See this line variable accuracy colon 1. You can increase the accuracy of my macro by changing the 1 to a 0. It will require more iterations, so you can decide if you want it to be quicker or more precise. Next, let's take a peek into macro CFG. Near the top, you'll see the line variable bed mesh calibrate target temp 60. This you can change to any temperature you'd like. I, for example, use 65 degrees for PLA. And the same temperature will be used for the Z-tilt alignment, unless you explicitly preheat to some other temp. And if you'd like mesh calibration to also work with custom preheat values, add this simple condition to the preheat line in the macro bed mesh calibrate. If printer.heater underscore bed.target less than 10, else printer.heater underscore bed.target vertical bar int. So these last two edits go in macro CFG, which doesn't get automatic backups like printer CFG does. So be sure to make a manual backup of it using the duplicate command and adding the current date and time to its name before making any changes to the original. With this, we've reached the end. Thank you for joining me in this little adventure. You're richer with this experience, and your printer is better thanks to these improvements. Now go print 3D.